Drag the equation to the correct graph. So let's look at these equations. We have y equals 4 divided by x. That's an inverse variation. Y equals 4x. That's a direct variation. Y equals 1/4 x. That's a direct variation. Y equals 1 divided by 4x. That's an inverse variation. Now let me go ahead and number these graphs. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, and I'm going to do the direct variation ones first because those are a little bit easier. Y equals 4x. We want a direct variation, and this constant of variation is a 4, which is also the slope. So we want a slope of 4 that goes through the origin or through the coordinate 0, 0. So that's this one right here, graph number 2. And then this next one, y equals 1/4 x. That's going to be a linear graph also through 0, 0 with a slope of 1/4. So this is going to be graph number 1 right here. And now it's between y equals 4 divided by x and y equals 1 divided by 4x. I'm going to use a test point just to see what happens here. And by comparing graphs 3 and 4, which are the two graphs we didn't use, I'm going to choose a value for x. I'm going to choose 1. So if I input a 1, that'll definitely tell which graph is which here. So y equals 4 divided by x, if that's 4 divided by 1, it's going to equal 4. Well, so that means 1, 4 is going to have to be a coordinate on the graph. So which graph has a coordinate of 1, 4? It's not this one. It's like this one right here, it's there. So this is going to be graph number 4. And let me do the same thing here. I'll substitute a 1. So y equals 1 divided by 4 times 1, which is 4. So the coordinate is 1, 1/4. And that looks like it could be 1/4 right there. So this will be graph number 3. Okay, so for the strategy here, I did the equations that I knew, and then used a test coordinate to figure out how the other graphs matched up.